In this segment, we'll look at an example how to find determinant of a matrix, a square matrix, by using minors. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, find determinant of this matrix here. 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1. So the determinant of a matrix is given as simply as if I'm going to find it out in terms of my any of the rows, it would be minus 1 times I plus j raised by I plus j aij times mij for any I is equal to 1, 2, and 3. So since it's a 3 by 3 matrix, I can choose any row. So I can choose I equal to 1 or 2 or 3, and then do this summation from j is equal to 1 to 3, where aij is simply the coefficient of the is the entry, ijth entry of the A matrix, and mij is the corresponding minor to that particular entry. So let's suppose I take the first row as my I. So let's suppose I choose I equal to 1. So what does that mean? What do I get determinant of A? I get determinant of A equal to summation j is equal to 1 to 3 minus 1 raised power 1 plus j a 1j times m 1j. So that's the formula which I'll have to use in order to be able to find out what determinant of A is. So let's go and see what, J will take the values of 1, 2, 3. So basically what that means is that I have to find M11, M12, and M13. So let's go and see what M11 is. So M11 minor will be simply equal to that I take out the first row and first column and find the determinant of the rest of it. So M11 will be take out the first row and the first column, and whatever is left over, find the determinant of that. So that's the determinant of what's left is 8, 1, 12, 1. So that will be this multiplied with this minus this multiplied with this. So it's 8 times 1 minus 1 times 12, and that gives you minus 4. So that's M11. Let's go ahead and find out the other minors as well. So M12 will be, you take out the first row and the second column out, and that'll be the determinant of the matrix. If you take the first row and second column out, you're left with 64, 1, and 144, and 1. So that gives you 64 times 1 minus 1 times 144, and that gives you minus 80. So that's M12. Similarly, let's go and find out what M13 is. So M13 will be, you take out the first row and you take out a third column, and what was left over, you find the determinant of that. So if you take the first row out and the third column out, you get 64, 8, 144, 12. And that's this times this minus this times this. So 64 times 12 minus 8 times 144, and that's minus 384. So we have found out all the minors which we need now. So as we were talking about, determinant of A will be equal to summation j is equal to 1 to 3 minus 1 raised power 1 plus j a 1j times m 1j. So if we expand this, we're going to get for the value of j equal to 1, I have a 1 plus 1 minus 1 raised to the power 2 will be equal to a positive number. So I'll get a11 here and m11 here. Plus, for j equal to 2, I get 1 plus 2 is 3, so minus 1 raised to the power 3 will be a negative number. So I'll get a12, m12. And what do I get it'll be minus here. It'll be minus here because it's minus 1 raised to the power 1 plus 2 is minus 1 raised to the power 3, and that's a negative number, so it'll be minus. Then the third one, term, which is j equal to 3, will be 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 is 4, so minus 1 raised to the power 4 is plus 1. So it'll be plus a 1 3 m 1 3. So So that's what I will get as my determinant. So A sub 1, 1 is nothing but 25. And the first minor M11, which we calculated, was minus 4. Then A12 is 5. And this M12, which I calculated, is minus 80. Plus A13 is 1. And the M13, which I calculated, is minus 384. And if I do this multiplication and the addition and subtraction operations, I get minus 100 here, minus plus 400 here, and minus 384 here, and that number turns out to be equal to minus 84. So that's how we find the determinant of the matrix by using minors. You could very well use any row or any column to find the determinant by using minors. Here we have just used the first row. You can repeat the process by using the second row or third row, or by first column, second column, and third column, and that's up to you. And still, the number which you get is minus 84. And that's the end of this segment.